A movie theater is filled to a capacity of 350. The theater charges $4.50 for children, $7.50 for students, and $12.50 for adults. There are half as many adults as there are students. If the total ticket sales was $2,415, how many children, students, and adults attended? So because we have three unknown quantities, we'll have to assign three variables for these values. So let's let x equal the number of children. Let's let y equal the number of students. And let's let z equal the number of adults. Now let's begin to write our system of equations. Well, since the theater is filled to capacity, x plus y plus z must equal 350. Next, we're told the price of each ticket, and we also know the total sales is $2,415. So every x is worth $450, every y is worth $750, and every z is worth $1,250. So we can say that 4.5x, where 4.5 represents $4.50, plus 7.5 times y, where 7.5 represents $7.50, plus 12.5 times z must equal the total sales of $2,415. And we're also told that there are half as many adults as there are students. So if there's half as many adults as there are students, the number of adults, z, would have to be equal to the number of students, y, divided by 2. Or we could do 1/2 times y. But again, whatever y is, the number of students, if we divide by 2, that would give us number of adults. And to avoid fractions here, though, we could multiply both sides of this equation by 2, giving us the equation 2z equals y, or y equals 2z. Let's use this equation instead to avoid fractions. So our third equation is y equals 2z. So this is the system of equations that we want to solve for x, y, and z to determine how many children, students, and adults were in the theater. Let's go ahead and do this on the next slide. To solve this system, we want to form two equations with two unknowns, and then we'll solve that system for one of the variables, and then perform back substitution to find the value of the remaining variables. And since this last equation is solved for y, we're going to perform substitution for y in the first and second equation. Since y is equal to 2z, we can substitute 2z for y here and 2z for y here. This will give us two equations with just x and z. So performing this substitution into the first equation, we would have x plus 2z plus z equals 350. Combining like terms, we would have x plus 3z equals 350. This is our first equation with two variables. Now I'll perform the same substitution into this second equation. So that would give us 4.5x plus 7.5 times 2z plus 12.5z equals 2,415. Well, 7.5 times 2z would be 15z. So if this is 15z plus 12.5z, that would be 27.5z. So now we have 4.5x plus 27.5z equals 2,415. So this is our second equation that again only contains two variables, the variable x and the variable z. So now we'll solve equation 1 and 2 as a system of two equations with two unknowns. So to keep this organized, let's go ahead and rewrite equation 1 and equation 2. We have x plus 3z equals 350, and then we have 4.5x plus 27.5z equals 2,415. And now to solve this system, let's go ahead and solve this first equation for x, and then perform substitution into the second equation. So if we solve this equation for x, we'd have to subtract 3z on both sides. That would give us x equals 350 minus 3z. And now we'll substitute 350 minus 3z for x in the second equation. And this will finally give us one equation with one unknown. We'd have 4.5 times 350 minus 3z plus 27.5z equals 2,415. Let's go ahead and finish solving this on the next slide. Let's go ahead and distribute here. 4.5 times 350 is 1,575. And then 4.5 times negative 3z would be negative 13.5z plus 27.5z equals 2,415. Combining like terms here, negative 13.5z plus 27.5z would be 14z. Now subtract 1,575 from both sides. That'd give us 14z equals 840. Divide both sides by 14. And we have z, which is the number of adults, equals 60. So we go back to the first slide. Let's go ahead and write this down. If z is 60, we know there were 60 adults. And I'll perform back substitution to find y and x. Well, we know that y is equal to 2 times z. So we have y equals, again, if z is 60, we have 2 times 60 for y, which is 120. And therefore, there would be 120 students. Notice there are half as many adults as there are students, as it says here. And finally, to find x, number of children, we know that x plus y plus z must equal 350. So x, the unknown, plus y, which is 120, plus z, which is 60, must equal 350. So this would be x plus 180 equals 350. Subtracting 180 on both sides, we would have x equals 170, which means there are 170 children in the theater. I hope you found this explanation helpful.